Do you spend hours creating lesson plans and presentations using Google Slides for your students? Let me show you how you can turn those hours into minutes using this AI tool, and it's all free. The Google Slides AI generator that I want to show you here today is by Elena. Elena has a number of AI tools that help educators that saves a lot of time. The one I want to focus on today is this slide generator, and I'll put the link to their site right below in the description so you can click on it. But then when you go to it, just go ahead and click on Install Slides Generator, and you'll see that you'll get to this point, and then you just have to go ahead and click Install. So once that's installed, I'll show you where to access it through Google Slides. I'm just going to go ahead and open up Google Slides here, and I am using the complete free version of this, what I'm here showing you here today. I'm going to go and create a blank presentation. Once you have Google Slides open, you just need to look in extensions here, and I've already added this in through the install through the link that I showed you, and it's right here, Elena for Google Slides. Create a presentation, we just need to click on that, and then we're going to get to the area where we insert our prompts and pick our customization of it. This is going to be a quick video because you're going to see how easy this is to use. First of all, I just want to point out this over here. You can see how many uses for the free beta that you get for this, and it's 3 per day or 10 per week. The other thing I want to point out, we can go for any topic. This is what we have selected. We could go slide by slide. So if we wanted to put a description in for each one, we can kind of help it with its prompt. And there's attachments. And I'll come back to that in a moment because I think this is a great option. So the information, the topic that we're going to do today is going to be effective presentations. So that's just my topic. In the prompt, I want to give it a little bit more information. Just like with any AI tool, you want to feed it as much information to keep it relevant to get what you want. And so in my case right here, I'm going to put this as my prompt, generate a slideshow to teach grade 6 students how to give presentations they'll be proud of. Now I could say this in a bunch of different ways, but I'm telling what to consider, adding examples, a mix of information, fun activities. And then as I go through, how many slides do I want this to be? So I could pick a number. I'm going to leave this one on auto. If I had notes that talked about effective presentations, I could go ahead and add that attachment. So I could go from device, from the web, YouTube URL, or anything I previously used. So I really like this because adding that attachment, it then helps you it's going to pull the information from that you trust and that you've already gone through and made sure it's what you want to use. These advanced options are really great too, because if I just open this up here, I like this web research mode. So now you can see it's on, off. I can just toggle everything on if I wanted to search the web. So if I have this off, it's not going to search the web. It's just going to use the large language model to go ahead and create the slideshow from the information. But if I wanted to use the web research, I can just turn this on. What's the output length, short, medium, long? I'm going to leave this as medium. Copyright free images, so I want to turn that on. And then you can go through AI generated. So all of these ones you can see that you can turn on or off. And do we want speaker notes? So all these different settings, I could go ahead and pick off how I want, and then you could say save my preferences. And then all we need to do is go create presentation. We can go ahead and pick the theme that we would like, and we can go through and change these after as well. So if I was just going to pick, let's say this first one here, the Sunshine Doodles, I can go from there and create presentations, and that's all there is to it. So this will usually takes about a minute, maybe 2 minutes, and then we'll have a presentation, and then we'll take a look at this. Let's see what we have here. So right away, they have our effective presentation. They have our title in here. If I just kind of click and look kind of what they've done, they've added images here. We have a little bit of text. I like how simple this is. The text is a little bit small, but I can quickly change that. You can change anything on here too. If you wanted to change the image, you could delete these, add a different image, use these as a placeholder. If I simply right click, I could go replace image, and you could upload maybe one you took from your computer or your Google Drive, I could quickly change themes as well. So if I click on, you can see how it's changed a few of these here, but I'm going to keep it with the theme that they have. Down at the bottom, I have the notes, for the speaker notes. And if I make this larger, you can see they have this ready for you to use part of your presentation. So that's a great option to help when presenting, just to give an idea of what to say, whether you follow them or not. But I'll just quick click on a few other slides and you get an idea of the format that they did. And based on my prompt of the different things that they put in here, so planning for the presentation, again, everything seems very simple to understand. You can see the notes for each of these slides too, how to make it interesting, talking about body language, tips for clear speaking, good visual aids, not so good visual aids, practice makes perfect. That's a good point to have here. Dealing with nervousness, they have a lot of great points in here. Tips for the presentation day, make a mini presentation, so a practice one, lots of great options. I will say, so if you do the same prompt again, it will create a different slideshow. So you can go through and try the same prompt again, or maybe tweak your prompt to get something more exact like what you want. But I hope this showed you a tool that's going to save you a lot of time when you don't know where to start and you just need that helping point, and then you go from there. Or you can see how good of a presentations that these do make with some minor tweaking can even make it look better. So check out Elena and see their other options they have with their AI tools for educators too as well, with the link down below. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.